When I perform at Persian functions, I often start by saying, "The most famous Persian comedian in the world is Maz Dobrani. You all wanted him here tonight, but you couldn't afford him. Therefore, you're stuck with me. Half is Persian, half is funny, but the good news, I'm also half the price." That invokes a big applause because it's real, it's funny, plus, if there's something Persian crowds love, it's knowing they got a good deal. Maz is truly a pioneer in the community. I've been lucky enough to call him a friend for over a decade. Over the years, he's helped a countless number of people in the industry. And when he asked me to go on tour with him, I was ready to jump for joy. This was not a deal to pass up. I was getting upgraded from performing in the back of pizza parlors to the biggest and best comedy clubs in the nation. I went from getting paid in chicken wings to actual U.S. currency. What's not to love? Most comedy shows start with the opening act or the feature comedian who goes up and warms up for the headliner. That was my job. We produce a little buffer as people arrive late, order drinks, and otherwise get settled in. The crowd is definitely not there to see you, and some evenings they make that more obvious than others. In the end, however, there's no pressure, because even if it didn't go that well for me, Maz would soon be on stage to save the show. On those nights, my relationship with the audience was like a standoff with playground bullies. "Oh yeah? You didn't like me, but soon my comedy big brother gonna be up here, and then you'll all be sorry." A few months into the tour, I got into the groove. I'd finally built up a strong 15 minutes on stage, and the crowd response was becoming more favorable. The word was getting out. You don't want to miss that first guy. I was lucky enough to perform with Maz for over 3 years across several countries. He introduced me to new fans in every major city, and I started getting booked on my own. As comedians tour, they often swap out who they work with every few years. So the day had finally come. It was time for me to go off on my own. Fly away, little bird. But one problem with going solo, oh man, the shows, they are not quite as glamorous anymore. The crowds aren't quite as enthused, the venues aren't quite as nice, and the pay, well, it's not quite as good. I guess you could say it was quite the fall from grace. Plus, I didn't have my comedy big brother to fall back on anymore. If a show went south, it was all on my shoulders. Another small caveat, instead of 15 minutes on stage, I was required to take the stage for 50 minutes. That's a big jump in maintaining the crowd's attention. There's no shortcut around this phase either. You just have to power through it. Sometimes fall flat on your face, go home, rewrite your jokes, cross your fingers, and hope next show you don't screw up as bad. All this while knowing you're probably still going to screw up just as bad. That's why when you see an established comedian, they often come off as really confident because they've been there, done that, and they have the battle scars to prove it. How is it that comics are not nervous while public speaking is most people's biggest fear? Well, because we do it every single night. Sometimes 4 shows per evening. And we've made people laugh at noon in Ohio and at 2 a.m. in Hollywood and everything in between. We've done comedy for conventions full of cops and in bowling alleys full of criminals. I've even had to send my jokes to government officials before in other countries for approval before I was even allowed to tell them. Which brings me to Dubai.